Hey everyone, it's Leif Johnson at Macworld, and if you've been interested in cases, I've been on the case. Look at this desk. This is exactly what my desk has looked like for weeks now, because I've been getting all these cases for the iPhone 11, the iPhone 11 Pro, and the iPhone 11 Pro Max. So I'm not gonna try on all of these right now, but today I'm gonna try to show you a good sampling of what I got. Don't think of these as reviews, think of these as impressions. I just wanna give you an idea of what's out there. So let's hop in. So I'm gonna start off with what I know right here for sure. So right here, this is Apple's clear case, and right here we have Spigen's clear case. Apple's is kind of rigid right here, whereas you can see that Spigen's is nice and kind of flexy. And so I'm just gonna put this on the 11 Pro, and you can see it's very done, but look at that, just from what I've been handling, Apple's is very sticky and stuff. Now it's hard, there's no question, it's got a good lip on there. You know, I don't feel uncomfortable dropping this thing, but let's try it with Spigen. And this is why I like theirs a little better. It's nice and flexy. And, ooh, it just slips on. And that kind of reminds me, you know, kind of like Apple's own silicone case, but without the flakiness. And look at there, it didn't even really have, I'm putting my fingers all over it. I just ate lunch. And there's not many fingerprints on it. And it's tough, it's got a nice lip on it. And it's supposedly got these little air cushions on the end. So right now, the way I'm looking for a favorite clear case, you know, this is the way to go. And there are plenty of people offering clear cases. Like, you know, I'm gonna move into the bigger stuff, but give you an idea too. Form-fitting cases are kind of nice. So here's from Tech 21. This is their studio color. It says yellow. It's dazzling Daylin, I believe is the color. But as you can see, you just slip it on very much like that. And yeah, they apparently say that you can this can drop up to 8 feet and you'd be okay. I'm a little skeptical of that, but you know, I've actually used this case for a day or so, and it gives you an idea of how thin some good cases are these days. OtterBox here, this is one of the symmetry cases. It has a good thing. The reason I like thin so much is just sitting here, got, you know, somewhat tight jeans, can just easily put this in my pocket. It's not a problem, it's grippy too. And so yeah, this is Tech 21. This is their studio color ones. And right here, I'm gonna try the OtterBox symmetry series, give you an idea. So it's kind of a similar case, a little bit more bulky. So you know, OtterBox is usually known for making these big cases. Yeah, this is a traditional OtterBox case. So I'll try that in a second. But as you can see, it's got that good old OtterBox protection going on, but it's not quite so bulky and stuff. You're still gonna feel comfortable putting this in your pocket. Yeah, yeah. And it's nice and grippy, so that gives you an idea. And so there's a nice little mid-range of phones here. And then, you know, see, this is the thing about the OtterBox. They want to make sure this thing didn't go anywhere, so it's not really coming off easily. And as you can see, the other ones were a lot easier to take off. I'm sometimes worried I'm gonna ruin my phone when I do this, like I'm gonna bend it or something. So fortunately, this isn't the iPhone 6. But, because I would be in trouble then. So moving off, as we're done, we'll throw them down here and give you an idea. Here's Casetify. This is another kind of like similar, you know, basic, you know, just your standard case. So the nice thing is these little bumpers on the edge. It's, ooh, this one, yeah, you gotta work the way in there. So this is a, yeah, this is Casetify. You know, oh, yeah, you can feel that. So when you dump that, it's got these little rubber bumpers on the side. Otherwise, it's a pretty, you know, bare bones case. But it's got those bumpers on it, and you can tell, even from what I was doing there, that makes a difference. So I like that. That's, yeah, that's Casetify. And, you know, they have many variations on colors and stuff. That's one of the nice things about Casetify. So you might notice that I was very proud of that lip when I was talking about the Spigen and, you know, even Apple's and stuff, because that protects your screen. I will tell you that, you know, it was last week. It was right before I got my new iPhone. 3 days before, I dropped and broke the screen on my iPhone XS Max. And I think that was because I was using one of these cases that didn't really have a lip. And so when I say that, that's that little bit of raised plastic around the screen that keeps your phone safe. I think that's a really important thing to look for. Almost, you know, just as important as the back. And so that's one of the reasons why I'm, you know, I kind of wonder about Totally's cases, because I love Totally. They're great. They, you know, it was kind of like I was saying about the Spigen ones, but even better. They have a better form fit. So you slip this on, and it's like, you know, it's like the case isn't even there. That's one of the nice things about Totally. Problem is, Totally is they're so good at that that you are basically hitting the ground right here. That's not nice. I mean, you can easily put this in your phone. This is the Pro Max. I'm gonna have a harder time doing that. But yeah, it gives you an idea. So I would watch out for that. It's gonna keep the back of your phone safe. I don't know if it has drop protection, but it's certainly gonna keep it safe from scratches and stuff. So that really, I think, drives home why I am very interested in these phones having a lip. But let's look at some novelty stuff here. Actually, let's start off with some protection. Okay, so UAG always likes to say that they got military drop testing. You know, it turns out that the military drop testing, I looked this up, it's only like 4.5 feet. That's why they're careful to say that it's like two times, really. So that means it's like 8 feet, which, to be honest with you, is pretty standard for a case drop test. But, you know, the thing is, this looks tough, yeah. So that's got the UAG on there, and they're really well known for that kind of thing. But, yeah, you put that on there, and yeah, it's... You know, if you're going for that rugged look, it helps. And it is certainly rugged. There's, you know, you got a nice, you know, edges on there and with the bump. And you're easily going to be able to slip this in your pocket. It's nice and grippy. I'd almost say it isn't as grippy as some of these, though. This is pretty slick back here. But, you know, this is the regular one. This is the Pathfinder. This is the UAG Pathfinder. So, you know, if you want to look a little bit more cool, you can get the Monarch version, which, you know, I kind of like that. I kind of like that red. And so this gives you an idea. And, yeah, so it's metal and stuff. Very nice. Fits very nicely. You probably heard that snap. I wonder if I'm going to have a hard time getting this off. And so very grippy. It's got, you know, very nice little rubber edge here. I would say you don't even hear that clack like you did with the other one because, yeah, everything out here. I don't even know if this is, I think it's just like faux leather on the back. I could be wrong. But, yeah, this your phone's going to be safe in this. And honestly, I think this kind of looks cool. So, you know, I'm glad to see that there's some really good options for tough stuff out there as well. So, and might as well, while we're talking about tough, let's get into the big one. Let's get to the OtterBox Defender. Yeah, this is when you want tough, this is what my mom, who lives on a ranch, this is what she gets. Yeah, so you go for OtterBox. So, look at that. It's got the belt clip. Told you. Yeah, and so, you know, yeah, you can take it out of this clip, but this one, yeah, so you slip it in there, so you have it facing you, and yeah, I just know, put it this way, you want tough, yeah, you go for OtterBox. I'm not even going to try to put this thing in there because it is a bit of a chore, because once you put something in an OtterBox case, it stays in there. I had to once actually look up how to take one out for my mom. But yeah, so if you're interested in that, they still have it, still got the belt loop, and that option's available. And I kind of like to see that some of these really established case makers are keeping that tradition going, where they're, you know, holding on to the really popular stuff. So, but I do also like to see that OtterBox is doing a good job of making slimmer stuff as well. This is from Grip2U. This is the Boost. So it's going in a different direction, and this is... It feels a little bit more plasticky. It's not as rubbery as the rest of them. So you put your finger in there, and that's the way you do that. So, you know, as opposed to like a pop socket where you put your finger around there, this is a little bit more secure. I don't know how comfortable I am talking like this. It feels like a chore just to get in there. This is also very rubbery. I have to wonder how well it's going to hold up, but apparently you can replace them. Now the cool thing about this, though, as opposed to there are other ones that don't have this, you know, you got a little stand on this one, on the Grip2U Boost. So, you know, so you can have it both ways. You know, if you want to hold it like this, you can do that. You know, if you want to use it as a little display, maybe even, you know, take along your Bluetooth keyboard and write. You know, it's nice. I like that they give you some options. Then well protected. It's got the lip I was telling you about. I mean, I'm a little bit concerned about that grip. It's still nice, but it's, you know, being a person who's prone to dropping his phone, I like to have a little bit more grip than that. This is from Pad and Quill. If you like leather products, Pad and Quill is really well known, you know, among Apple folks, and because they've been doing this, especially this is the Bellafino. It's the wallet case. They've been doing this for a long time. So, you know, this is nice. You got one, 2, 3, 4 slots for cards here. You can do a little display in here. And you just set your phone in. Now, you know, I'm a person that takes a lot of photos, so I kind of find these kind of cases annoying because, you know, this is the way you end up taking photos. And if you want to do it better, you're not. But it's got a new, you know, you can actually replace these now. They changed this design. So that's cool. And yeah, so if you're a big fan of that, I love this ampersand logo on the outside. You just do that, and that's definitely going to keep your phone safe. That's both sides of that. You got, you know, something on the screen there. So I like that. So Pad and Quill doing its stuff. Now, on a similar note, while we're on the subject of leather, here is one from Nomad. And so Nomad has a wallet case, but, you know, Nomad makes very tough stuff, and they're really good. I don't know if this is one of the Horween leather ones. It is. This is Horween leather. So that means after a while, this will develop this beautiful patina. And so this one only has 3 cards, though. Notice that it has no little window for your ID. I mean, but it is quite pretty, though. I believe this is the Max version. And, yeah, but it also has no elastic strap. You know, it's like a moleskin notebook. And whereas that, yeah, it doesn't close all the way, you know. And especially when you put some cards in there, that, you know, you're gonna want to worry about that. So that gives you an idea of what to look out for when, you know, you're trying to get different cases. So give you an idea of these cases right side by side. Similarly, on a note, they are. Let me see. I want to put this in here. So give you an idea. This is Waterfield. They're right here in San Francisco. They make really great products and stuff. But instead of like a case this year, what they made is a sleeve. So you can have it with, you know, a phone or without. And I don't know, yeah, I would have to take this out of the case. This one is actually bison leather. So yeah, but notice I have my case in there. I have a case on it. And yeah, this is actually Spigen's case. They made it for Apple's case. But yeah, so if you want that extra protection, like to throw it in your bag, here's your bison leather sleeve that you can throw it in. So that's a nice little leather thing. And it fits around a case. That's really important. So, you know, when you go to their site, it'll tell you whether or not you want to do it with a case or not. I was talking about the grips, you know. Let's go ahead and look at the Otter Pop, which actually has pop sockets built right into it. Let me take this Pro Max out here so I don't break it like a fool. And so nice and colorful. As I've gotten older, I've kind of liked colorful stuff more. But, you know, these have become, cases like this have become really popular. And, you know, OtterBox does a good job of making it where it's built right into it. So, yeah, so there you go. You know, this is the way you hold that. And, you know, once again, got that famed OtterBox toughness, you know. You know, you're not going to do much to that. If you want to prop it up, you can. And, you know, not as effectively, as you can see, as you were doing the grip to you. But yeah, so you have those options. I'll also give you another leather one. This is also from Nomad. For more leather, here we have Nomad again. To give you this is, you know, if you're not going to go for their wallet case, this is what you go for. This one, you know, I guess the brown one is in the pack here. But this is the black one. So this is leather as well. But yeah, you put it in there, and this is the active rugged case. So this one probably won't develop a patina. You're gonna kind of feel it and stuff, but it also has a degree of water resistant. Yeah, water resistant leather. And whereas the other ones, you know, they're not really that water resistant. Fortunately, the phone is. But yeah, if you wanna keep that case itself done. So it gives you an idea. There is a lip here, but it's not as great as I would want. You know, it can still do that. I've seen that a lot this year. A lot of cases are really good at slipping these in, you know, making it where you can still slip these in your pocket. You know, people talk about how they're okay with thicker phones, but I think that's one of the reasons why Apple makes thin cones if phones is, you know, when you look at the bumps, it's almost like they intend for you to put a case around it, because in a lot of places, especially in the last models, the XS and stuff, it's set flat. But gives you an idea. Yeah, it's got bumpers around here. That's the thing on the main leather ones. This would just be leather, whereas this would be a bumper. And so it's very bouncy. I like that. Nomad, you know, aims towards hikers and rugged folks like that and stuff. Speaking of target audiences, let's look at Razer. Razer is typically known, you know, for its gaming peripherals. And in this case, you have the famous screaming black and, you know, and green neon they are famous for. So in this case, this is a thermoprene Thermaffine, yes. And what this does is this actually cools off your phone if you're playing games a lot. I actually played a lot of Sayonara Wild Hearts on my phone, and it never warmed up. So I was wondering if I would need this case. But so it's good technology to have. Now, I will say it is actually pleasantly grippy. This is a beautifully grippy phone, and look at that. That's actually, no. Yeah, compared to some of them, but it's... I'm not going to be too worried if I bother it. There's a bit of a lip here. You can slip this into your phone just fine. And, you know, looks good with the phone, especially with my midnight green here. So it's, yeah. They also have a slim version of it, but it doesn't have that thermophane layer. This is the one I was looking for a minute ago when I said I was looking for grippy. This is a Smartish, their Gripzilla case. This is both, it's protective. It's relatively thin. It's not as thin as some of these other ones, like totally, but it's still relatively thin. And it's got bumpers on it, like some of the other ones. And it does actually have little handles for grip here. This is pleasant to hold. I do not feel like I'm gonna drop this thing. Gripzilla is a nice, yeah. And that even feels satisfying, yes. So I'm not that worried about that. So this is Smartish Gripzilla, and I actually kind of like it, so. Yeah, if you want one that's kind of like a good all around, you know, it's protective, it's grippy, and it slips into your pocket. Yeah, Smartish Gripzilla. And they actually have a pretty extensive line here. You know, here's like the teal Gripzilla. So it gives you an idea of like multiple color options too. So, let's see here. We have Sonics, you know. Getting back into some of the standard cases here, you know, that you're used to seeing. Yeah, so I thought we'd go on the wild side here. So, this is, you know, so among all the rest of them, it's got a kind of like, you know, feels like glassy, plasticky back, but it does have a nice bumper on the side. So, you know, if you want a little bit more personality, Sonics has a lot of cases like this. You know, when I put the image up on our, you know, roundup of the best cases coming up, that's going to be a very, it's just going to have that one, but you're going to have so many to choose from. You know, Casery is another one, but I believe you only have two options here, so that gives you an idea. You know, it's another one that could be colorful, so, you know, same basic thing. The bumper is not as nice, but Casery, it looks nice, but I believe you literally only have two options with this. And Moshi has some nice cases this year. So, for instance, we have this one, and so what this is the Eye Glaze. This is the Moshi Eye Glaze slim hard shelled case. It is literally hard. When I picked these up, I was thinking it was it was going to be like some of this rubbery material and stuff. No, it's not, and it's got that snap to stuff on there, so that might actually be part of it, because you know you can use this for wall mounts and stuff like that, so that's built into there. And it's nice, and it looks kind of classy, and I'm not sure if that would hold up, but the edges are kind of, they're glossy, they're not really, you know, they don't really have that fall bumper, but it does have a nice lip here. So yeah, that's the Moshi Eye Glaze, and you can tell from the glaze that yeah, they're really going for that kind of sleek feel. But this is a nice sturdy case. So far, I haven't really seen anything that I hated, so I would keep that in mind. But here we have Pelican, and so this is an interesting car. So in this case, yeah, you can see we're getting a little bit more involved here. So we have this case. So this is the interesting thing. Now, I don't know how well I'm gonna be able to set this up here, but you have the base case, so you don't have to go around like Apple's own battery case and walk around, with this big bulky thing in there. You could just walk around like this. And that's, you know, it's more logical these days because the batteries last a long time. But if you're going on a trip or something, you can attach, look at that. It's very nice. It just attaches to it. Now, you are gonna knock that off in your, you know, but this would be nice if you're like carrying it around and stuff like that, and the battery. So this is actually a battery pack that is actually on its phone itself, and it's magnetically charging. That's another thing I should say, that all of these cases support magnetic charging. And so when I write to my roundup I will make sure to point out if they don't, because that would be, at this point, it would be an exception to the rule as opposed to a feature. So all of these cases should generally support wireless charging. And, you know, I haven't even seen a reason to include it as a separate category. Give you an idea of some of the other, you know, options you'll have. This is the Moshi Ultra. Moshi makes it pretty difficult to get into their stuff, so pardon my barbarianism. That's, yeah, like this one has a little lanyard on it. Yeah, so you can put that on there. Point being that you put this on there and you would hold it around your wrist. And I imagine if you have an actual lanyard, you can actually just, you know, attach it to that, put it around your neck if you want to. So yeah, it's nice to see the case makers offer so many things. And I have to admit, in a lot of ways though, I find myself still gravitating to some of the simpler stuff. Like this is the Gear 4 Crystal Palace Neon. Yeah, look at that. It's decently protective. A little bit thicker than like that Spigen. And it's just, oh, I like that. Yeah, so that's Gear 4. Cause yeah, I was ready to wince up there, but no, that sounded perfectly safe. I like that. And you can tell when I feel comfortable with these cases because I'm just letting myself bang them around. We have the Smartish, the Dancing Queen, also a lanyard one. But in this case, this one has a wallet attached to it. So, you know, you can actually put a lanyard on here and and you attach it, perfect. You just go around and it looks very nice. And Smartish in particular has a nice roundup of different things. It's one of the things that makes this really hard to pick out the best one because, you know, to stay in the fight, really, a lot of these case makers are making some really interesting stuff these days. We have Inkipio. They have, you know, this is another one where, you know, this kind of reminds me of OtterBox where it's the protection. And I'm not even gonna try to, wait. Oh yeah, I can feel that. That's, if you're looking for like a really grippy material, okay, see, this is why I need to look at this stuff. Yeah, so this feels kind of plasticky and rubbery, but it's also very grippy. And you know, I imagine it'd be nice if you're a fan of this type of color. I like how it kind of glows. And so you got the protection going on. And this is really nice. And actually, I'm using the wrong phone. Actually, this might actually be one of the rare iPhone 11. As you probably noticed, I've been using the Pro and the Pro Max for almost everything. But this one's actually an 11. So, oh my God, and the color even matches. So that gives you an idea. That's the iPhone 7 in the green. And this is very nice. Got a the lip around it. Can easily slip it in. Yeah, and put it in your pocket. And it actually says, go ahead and drop me on the case. And 11 feet. That's what they're saying for case drops. I can believe it. Boy, all this would have been nice the other day when I broke my phone. We're winding down here. You know, as we started off with Spigen, but just give you an idea. You know, I always think they make good stuff. But so here's a smaller one. This is the Tough Armor. So, you know, before we had the clear one. Yeah, that looks tough. I can't figure out if this, yes, it's got a cute little kickstand on it. Yes. Okay, you're supposed to use it like that. So yeah, this one's got the Tough Armor, and I actually used to have a version that was very similar to this back in the day. So I think with my iPhone 7. And this feels like a good one to do this. Yeah, I'm not worried about that. Yeah, that's good. Notice it is a little bit harder on the edges here. You know, I do like some of these cases I've showed you where it's all the way around, but it's mainly, you know, these tipping points. But nice to take off. You know, I know this is probably just a me thing, because this is one of the things I have to do, but I really like it when it's easy to take these cases off. And then LifeProof makes some really popular ones. So, and this one is the Slim. So you have their bumper going around, but the back here is very clear. So I believe this might actually be the, no, that's not. Harder to put in. Okay. Yeah, that thing's not going anywhere. So, but yeah, that's, yeah, LifeProof, living up to the name. That's very nice. You get, you know, a lot of people are liking clear backs and everything, so you can see the beauty of like this midnight green and everything this year. But yeah, as far as the edges, certainly not the front screen. I'm not worried about that. That is the LifeProof. Oh, I said slim. It's the LifeProof Slam. So it gives you an idea. We have a very hard looking concrete floor. I am not going to test it here. So I will close this off with two of these. This is Casemate, you know, gonna make sure that we have one of the big names out here. This is Casemate's, and this is another one where they offer all kind of colors. And this one is different because it has a very, it is. You know, when I did the roundup of phones that you actually have available, you know, right after the launch, this was one of them. That's nice. That's really nice. If you want this like groove, but yeah, this is nice. So there's that one. Yes, and that is the Casemate Tough Groove. And I believe it lives up to its name. And it's got 10 feet of drop protection. And yeah, it's very good to see that they're all doing it. So what is, you know, got one more from Moshi. This is a wallet case, you know, but you can actually take the case out. So it was kind of similar to the battery, but this is what the, you know, you can actually remove the case and move, you know, take it separately. I wonder how that, well, that works though, because of Pad and Quill, there was one I think they had where it didn't work out so well if you took it out. But this one is Survivor from Griffin. This will close us out here. And I got another Survivor here. So, okay, well this, I was, when I was looking at it, especially with that logo and stuff, I was expecting something like, you know, an OtterBox or something. But no, this is pretty plasticky. And I'm gonna say it's very rubbery. That's not a mark against it. Okay, so yeah, this is on the iPhone 11. Yeah, now it's very simple, bare bones, got a nice lip around it, would easily slip into my pocket, very grippy, and because this is very slick, as you can see. Notice too that this isn't leaving fingerprints like Apple's own. So you know that's a real bad mark against Apple's is how easily it picks up fingerprints. But that, you know, it gives you an idea of what my days have been like lately. But this has been a good sampling of all the cases we have. We've seen cases a lot of options. They got lanyards, they can cool off, you know, if you're gaming too hard, or you just got regular old simple stuff that, you know, can still be thin and provide like 10 feet of drop protection. I think that's really amazing. And the next day or so, I'm gonna do a roundup all these, and I'm gonna do best of clear cases, best of leather cases, best of wallet cases, and I'll categorize all that for you. Picked all the rest of them. I'm still getting cases in. I'll still be getting cases in for the rest of the year. As those come in, I'll add stuff, I'll switch stuff out and everything. But that'll be on Macworld, and I'm just putting in one big thing this year. It's gonna be best iPhone 11 cases, you know, 11 Pro, 11 Max, you know, in every style. And so we'll have different, you know, price points for each one and stuff that you could look at. But anyway, thanks for sticking around for this, and I hope I give you an idea of what's available for sale and, you know, what you can get and all the different options that are available, because it's pretty amazing this year. And anyway, for more information on iPhone cases, stick with Macworld.